Dermot Lynch has said in a letter to Pierce Beasley that there was no man in closer touch with Collins than himself.
It has been suggested that, due to the close friendship between the IRB comrades Dermot Lynch and Michael Collins, that Collins had a hand in organising Lynch's secret wedding.
Dermot Lynch and Collins had collaborated at the end of 1917 and early 1918 on the revision of the Sinn Féin Constitution, the IRB Constitution, and the reorganisation of Irish volunteers. In early 1918, food scarcity was an issue for many Irish people because of increasing exports to England due to them being at war with Germany during World War I. And it was in February 1918 where Dermot Lynch masterminded the seizure of a herd of pigs being driven from the market. They were seized by 24 men led by Lynch. Waiting butchers slaughtered the pigs and the meat was sold to local consumers. The Sinn Féin party repaid the owners for their animals. The Cork Examiner described the pig seizure offence as a startling and unparalleled outrage. Dermot Lynch's co-prisoners were Ernest Blyde, Frank Thornton, Dick McKee and Terence McSweeney. In the coming years, all these men would play a part in Collins' life.
In April 1918, Dermot Lynch was informed that he was to be deported to the USA. He asked for permission to marry his fiancée, Kathleen Quinn of Newbridge, County Kildare, so that she could apply for a passport to travel to the USA with him as his wife. This was refused, so he quietly, with the help of his Republican comrades outside, made the marriage arrangements in Dundalk Jail. Kathleen Quinn, with her sister Carmel and Capuchin priest Reverend Father Aloysius Travers, had travelled from Dublin to Dundalk on the morning train. They were escorted into the visitors' room at Dundalk Jail and were joined by the Republican prisoners whom they had officially requested to see. Meanwhile, the engaged couple, Lynch and Kathleen Quinn, were grouped in a hushed exchange with the priest. Dermot Lynch, a member of the Supreme Council of the IRB, Irish Republican Brotherhood, and Kathleen Quinn were married at noon by Father Aloysius Travers.
After he had announced his marriage to his co-prisoners, Lynch was immediately moved from his cell and placed on a train for Dublin with the armed detectives Patrick Smith and Daniel Hoey. In 12 months, Collins would be paying close attention to those detectives, Smith and Hoey. Lynch arrived in Amiens Street Station, now Connolly Station, and was met by a number of well-wishers, including De Valera and Collins. Harry Boland, who had met Lynch at the station, informed him that the volunteers were prepared to attempt a rescue. Lynch thought it would be a bad idea, as many men would be shot. As Lynch entered the Black Maria, his wife and friends joined him, along with De Valera. The volunteers, who were led by Harry Boland and Michael Collins, marched in front of the Black Maria along the quays to the Bridewell. The following morning, Collins had also joined Dermot and Kit on the train to Kingstown.